I can feel your presence in my life. You go before me, yet you always lead me on. You guide me with your gentle hand. You know my movements when I sit and when I stand. I know you are always here. I can feel your presence in my life. I know you are always near. I can feel your presence in my life. I can feel your presence in my life. I can feel your presence in my life.
Let us feel the presence of the Lord in our lives. Oh Lord, I know that you are here. I know, Lord, that you are close to me. Where can I go, Lord? You are the source of life. Only you can understand me better. Yes, Lord. I want to feel your presence, Lord. I want to feel your presence in my senses. In my hearing. In my seeing. In my touch, my taste, my smell, these are the areas, these are our senses, Lord, wherein we take all the data and we process in our minds and in our hearts. And at this moment, I want you to fill all my senses with your holiness, with your mercy, with your love, with your righteousness. At this moment, let us bend our heads. Let us worship the Lord. Let us adore Him. Let us speak to the Lord. Lord, here I am. Maybe right now we feel very low because I don't go for Mass. I don't participate in the retreats. I don't get a chance to go for confessions. And I feel lonely. And the Catholic Church teaches us that we need to confess to a priest. And maybe with this burden of sin, frustration, anger. We are burdening our lives. So we feel that something is lacking in us. There is a drop of spirituality somewhere. But still, Lord, you are with me. As a father embraces the son, the prodigal son who comes back after spending everything what he had, he fought with his father. He took everything from his father. He took his share. He went away. He ruined his life. And later on, he came to his senses. That is why whatever we feel from our senses, whatever we see, whatever we hear, whatever we feel, whatever we touch and smell, those are the windows, those are the doors of our lives wherein the data enters in. And through these doors and windows, the good can come in and also the bad. The prodigal son sensed it. And he was wrong. He came back. And the father hugged him. The father was looking at him. At this moment, Jesus is looking at us. Let us run to him. Let us thank and praise him for everything. Maybe I have lost my life. Maybe I have lost my job. Maybe my family members have died. Maybe my wife, my children, my husband, my relatives, my friends, whoever it is. God knows the best. Let us thank him. Let us praise him for giving us a life. He is the King of glory. He rules the earth above, the earth below, and also on the earth. There is nothing in this world or in this space that God doesn't own. Everything is his own. Hosanna to you, Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Not only we, Lord, but the whole generation. And the generations yet to come wants to bow down and praise you, Lord. The only one language of angels is singing Hosanna to you. I want to see you, Lord. I want to glorify you, Lord. And Hosanna means glorification, exaltation. Let the salvation be with me. Heal my heart, Lord, and make it clean so that I can adore you. Open my eyes, Lord, that I can see you. Open my ears, Lord, that I can hear you. Open my senses, Lord, that I can feel you, I can touch you, I can taste you. I can smell you. Open my senses right now, Lord. So that from my depths of my heart, I can sing to you, Hosanna.
Hosanna in the highest.
thank you, Lord, and praise you, Lord. We worship you, we adore you, Lord, for all the blessings you have bestowed upon us. Wherever we are right now, we know that we can see, we can hear, we can feel. And this is the same touch, Lord, from you. Years back, I had received. Not knowing your mercy, not knowing your forgiveness, not knowing your love, I was astray, Lord. I did not know to do my choice. But still, Lord, you help me, you guide me. But still, in this world and in the history, Lord, we have seen the humans disobey you right from the creation until date. We do the same. Genesis 3, now the snake was the most cunning animal that the Lord God had made. The snake asked the woman, did God really tell you not to eat fruit from any tree in the garden? We may eat the fruit of any tree in the garden, the woman answered, except the tree in the middle of it. God told us not to eat the fruit of that tree or even touch it. If we do, we will die. The snake replied, that's not true. You will not die. God said that because he knows that when you eat it, you will be like God and know what is good and what is bad. The woman saw how beautiful the tree was and how good its fruit would be to eat. And she thought how wonderful it would be to become wise. So she took some of the fruit and ate it. Then she gave some to her husband, and he also ate it. As soon as they had eaten it, they were given understanding and realized that they were naked. So they sewed fig leaves together and covered themselves. That evening, they heard the Lord God walking in the garden, and they hid from him among the trees. But the Lord God called out to the man, where are you? He answered, I heard you in the garden. I was afraid and hid from you because I was naked. Who told you that you were naked? God asked. Did you eat the fruit that I had told you not to eat? The man answered, the woman you put here with me gave me the fruit and I ate it. The Lord God asked the woman, why did you do this? She replied, the snake tricked me into eating it. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
My dear friends, as we heard in this passage, that God creates the full atmosphere with a lot of things. There are plants, animals, there is land, there is water, the things, the living creatures in the water, on the land, in the skies, He created all of them. And the most important creation was the man. And God planted them as husband, wife in a beautiful garden. And God told them, you have the authority over everything except one tree which is in the middle. Please don't go close to it. Don't touch it. Don't eat the fruits. It might be beautiful. It might be tempting. Let us reflect in our own lives. Which is the tree in our life which is in the center, which tempts us? There are so many things in our life which is in the center. The tree was in the center of the garden, and God told them. The clear instruction, the laws were given to them not to eat the fruit. In our lives too, in the garden of our life, we plant this tree. It is there. It is hidden. No doubt, we do all the work around it. We enjoy the atmosphere around it. But there is a time, maybe through a friend, the Adam and Eve was tempted through a snake, maybe through a friend, maybe through our own senses, our thoughts, our studies, our qualifications. We feel like to experience that one thing which is in the center of our life garden. And when we eat that, we realize that, yes, we are wise. We realize that we are naked. And we hid. Adam and Eve hid themselves. They were scared. When we touch the sin, we get scared. We can't see God. We feel we are ripped away. We are naked right now. And we need to hide from the Lord. What is the main tree in our life? Is it the tree of anger, hatred, jealousy, unforgiveness, some unseen sins, pornography? What is it? It's a question for each one of us. Maybe I pretend that I am good. Maybe I act like a Pharisee. If someone sees me, yeah, he's great. He's doing a lot of work. He's so holy. But we know deep within us, and our God knows what we do. The woman saw the fruit, the senses again, the eyes. She ate it, she tasted, she heard. The eyes, the ears, the feeling, the touch, the smell of the fruit. The taste was involved. All five senses were involved. What are we doing about our senses? We need to put a filter. We need to filter our senses so that only good things come in. It is difficult, my dear friends. It is difficult. It is difficult for me too. But the filter of God's mercy, God's love, God's care, that will help us to keep away the bad things which will enter through our senses. It is a choice God gives Adam and Eve. In our lives, we make a lot of choices. If it is a good choice or a bad choice, it is a choice. In Sirach, we find in Sirach 15, 11 onwards, we find the passage of free will. Don't blame the Lord for your sin. The Lord does not cause what He hates. Don't claim that He has misled you. He doesn't need the help of a sinner to accomplish His purpose. The Lord hates evil in all its forms. And those who fear the Lord find nothing attractive in evil. When in the beginning the Lord created human beings, He left them free to do as they wished. If you want to, you can keep the Lord's commands. You can decide whether you will be loyal to Him or not. He has placed fire and water before you. Reach out and take whichever you want. You have a choice between life and death. You will get whichever you choose. The Lord's wisdom and power are great, and he sees everything. He is aware of everything a person does, and He takes care of those who fear Him. He has never commanded anyone to be wicked or given anyone permission to sin. My dear friends, God tells us very clearly, it is your choice. Whatever choice you do, it is up to you. Only thing, you need to face the consequences later. The fire and the water is in front of you. The hell and the heaven is in front of you. It is your choice to go there. So today, transform your lives. Transform your senses. Transform your mind and heart. And when we surrender our life into God's hand, He makes a way. Sometimes we feel God is not here, God is not close to me, God is not listening to me. But He has its own time and way. Maybe the roads are rough. We can see only desert in front of us. But we need to walk in this desert so that we can get water oases and mates of the deserts. What is our choice? Where do we want to head? What is a free will? What is a choice? We can't blame for wrong things. And we can't point God for the wrong things what we do. Nothing wrong comes from God. Today we might blame God. Why the virus, Lord? Can't you take it? See the changes in the atmosphere, the climate change. All of us are robbing us. Our own leaders robbing us. They are killing the people. They are not understanding their feelings. They are lying. Where are you, Lord? Wrong doesn't come from God. It is the human being who chooses. It is his choice. And in this midst of the darkness, let us call to the Lord. And yes, he will make a way for us. Let us look at Jesus. Let us tell him our troubles. Let us tell him what situation we are right now. Oh Lord, I need healing from you. I need your touch, Lord. You are the living water. I am thirsty, Lord. I want to drink from you, Lord. I am hungry. I want to eat from you, Lord. All those who are burdened, come to me, says Jesus. So let us fall at his feet and tell him, Lord, you are the life giver. I want to come to you, Lord. I accept that I am weak. I fall. I'm fragile. I know the choices, Lord, which I made in my life was wrong. That is why I'm searching you, Lord. Let us go to this river, which is full of life. It is not a dead sea, wherein there is no life. But this is a river, this is a sea, this is an ocean of life. I want healing, Lord, right now. Emotional healing, Lord. Physical healing. Spiritual healing, Lord.
Come
if your soul is thirsting. Draw near and drink of the mercy of Jesus Christ at the river of life. Draw near and drink of the mercy of Jesus Christ at the river of life.
Jesus Christ.